follows. Rule 2. The viewer must achieve magnetic purity for theory of life. He must attain the dispelling radiance which shows itself in every man when he has moved the centers in the head. When this magnetic field is established, the radiation too is exposed. The significance of this will be somewhat apparent to the advanced esoteric student. As you know, magnetic field is established when the powerful vibration of the center in front of the pituitary body and the center around and above the pineal gland swing into each other. Controversial point in connection with the above rule, which we shall have later to consider, is how and in what manner magnetic purity is to be achieved, and how the two centers in the head can form together one magnetic field. Later, in our conclusion, which is intensely practical, I will touch upon these two points. One of the things which should definitely emerge in our studies is the fact that disease is seldom of individual origin, unless a man misspends his life and definitely misuses his body through drink or sexual dissipations, and that the bulk of the disease to be found in the world today is almost entirely of brick origin, is inherited, is the result of infection, or the result of undernourishment. The last named cause is primarily an evil of civilization. It is the result of economic maladjustment or the corruption of food. As I earlier pointed out, these latter causes of disease are not primarily the result of inner subtle forces, but are the pouring upwards, into the etheric body, of energies from the physical plane itself and from the outer world of forces. Been assigned by occult teachers to these forces which come from without, which originate upon the physical plane, and which affect the inner body. There are physical energy and streams of force entering into the etheric bodies of all forms, just as the world illusion and the miasmas of the astral plane all have their causes. Entering into the centers of man from the subtler levels have often been considered in occult books, but the forces which find their way into the centers from the world of physical plane life are seldom realized or discussed. This is a somewhat new thought which I offer for your consideration. Copyright 1998 Lucid Trust. 19. A Treatise on the Seven Rays. Volume 4, Esoteric Healing. I have asked AAV to insert a very brief synopsis of some of the points I have already made under the heading, What is Disease? I suggest the following. 1. All disease is disharmony and lack of alignment and control. A. Disease is found in all the four kingdoms in nature. B. Definite methods of healing are peculiar to humanity, and mental in origin. 2. Disease is a fact in nature. A. Antagonism to disease simply energizes it. B. Disease is not the result of wrong human thought. 3. Disease is a process of liberation and the enemy of that static. 4. The law of cause and effect governs diseases as governs all else in manifestation. I found also that healing is brought about in three ways. 1. Through the application of the methods of the many schools of medicine and surgery, and allied groups. 2. Through the control of the astral body. This book is practically the first one ever given out to the public on this theme. Much has been given in the past on the subject of the physical body and its care, both by exoteric and esoteric science. Much of it is true, and some of it is illusion. It is illusion because it is based on false premises. The modern esotericists have dealt with the subject of the etheric body, and this too has been partially true and partially false. Statement is not a truth. Remember, how can it be entirely true when we consider the limitations of your power to comprehend? It is impossible for me to convey to you the truth, because there exists neither the terminology nor an adequate groundwork of knowledge on your part. This makes my task difficult. This teaching on healing is likewise the hardest I have yet undertaken. For two reasons. First, the real nature of the brain, the subtle body, is somewhat meaningless, is it not? They are not bodies like the physical body. They can be regarded as centers or reservoirs of particular types of force, attached to each individual, possessing their proper and lesson outlet. They are collections of atoms, vibrating at high speed and color, according to some controls of the chromosome, by certain definite moves, with certain tone, and are at varying points of evolution. According to others, they are states of consciousness and can regard them as made in the likeness of a man. Look at your definition, brother of mine. The astral body is, for the majority of mankind, the nature of the body has to be considered. It is an outstanding Again into manifestation.